Hello everyone, DonellHD here, and today I'm going to show you how to set up, configure, and install the Sony PlayStation 4 emulator ShadPS4 on Launchbox. As per usual, I have my arcade folder here, and inside that folder, I have my emulators folder, my Launchbox folder, and the ROMs folder where we're keeping our ROMs. Inside this folder, I've created a folder called Sony PlayStation 4, and I've placed two ROMs in it. Make sure your format says .pkg. I left the Dropbox link for everything that you're going to need to get set up right away. All you have to do is click here on download. All right, I've downloaded my PS4 Necessities file and I've placed it here on my desktop. What I'm going to do now is extract the contents of it into the emulators folder. Now I'm going to run the emulator for the first time. So I'm going to go into emulators, ShadPS4, PS4 emulator, and the ShadPS4 EXE here. Alright, when we first open it up, the first thing it's asking for is the directory to install your games. Like I said, I placed mine on the desktop arcade ROMs folder. So I'm going to click that directory here. Browse, arcade, ROMs folder, Sony PlayStation 4. And I'm going to click select folder here. Now I'm going to click OK. Alright, now that it's fully opened, I'm going to go ahead and go into the gear icon here. And I'm going to click on graphics. If you feel you need to increase your resolution, I wouldn't go any higher than 1920 by 1080. You can change that here by doing that, but I'm going to keep mine at 1280 by 720 just to keep you safe. Whenever you plug your controller in, it's automatically configured, so you don't have to do any configuration at all for that. I already enabled full screen, so if you don't want that checked in, you can uncheck that. And I also have it automatically checking for updates nightly. So if you do not require that, you can just uncheck here. Now I'm going to click save. So the next step is going to install our games into the emulator. So I'm going to go up here to file, install packages. And here are my two ROMs here. So I'm going to select the first one here. And it asks which directory would you like to install it to. We've already set it here. So I'm going to click OK. And now it's installed. Keep in mind, large games take a long time to install. Now I'm going to do my next one. File. Install packages and install the next game. Make sure your ROM directory is here. Click OK. And click OK when you're done. Now, if you're done here, you can go ahead and double click on these games to launch them. But I'm going to go ahead and set these up in Launchbox, so that's what we're going to do now. So let's set this emulator up in Launchbox. All right, now that we're here in Launchbox, we're going to go up here to the top left corner here. We're going to go to Tools. Manage emulators. I'm going to click add. The emulator name is ShadPS4, or you can name it whatever you like. Now we're going to set the path. Once again, it's on my desktop, arcade, emulators, ShadPS4, and the PS4 EXE here. In the default command line parameters, type -G. Now I'm going to go to associated platforms, and the associated platform I'm going to put here is Sony PlayStation 4. And I'm going to set this as my default emulator here. Now we're going to go to the running script area, and I left the script in the description below that if you require it, you can escape out of the emulator easily by pressing the escape key. I'm going to paste that here. And now I'm going to click OK. And then close. Now it's time to add our games. When importing your game ROMs, simply go to your ROMs folder, and inside that folder, you should have folders created, which were created when you added your games inside of ShadPS4. Simply go up here to your search box and type eboot.bin. Drag these two files into Launchbox like so. What type of files are you importing? Click ROM files. What platform are you importing games for? Select Sony PlayStation 4. Next. What emulator would you like to use? Make sure ShadPS4 is selected here. Next. Use files in their current location. Next. 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 Uncheck combine ROMs with matching titles into a single game, so you'll get both ROMs on the screen. Next. And as you can see here, It imported both games as the same name, so you need to change those. So make sure you correspond your folder name to the name of the ROM. So I'm going to go here and I'm going to type in Blade Strangers because that's the name of the game I'm importing. Once you're done, click Finish. All right, now that our games are imported, let's test them out. Here's Mighty Morphin Power Rangers Mega Battle. And finally, here's Blade Strangers. Thank you everyone for watching. If this video helped out at all, support the channel and drop a like and subscribe. I've created many tutorials for other platforms as well. Just follow the thumbnails on the screen. As always, I'm DonellHD, and I'll see you guys in the next video. Take care.